Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. I have a fun long weekend planned, so let's get into it. Today is Thursday and I'm off to Covent Garden to attend an Elemis pop-up. This is to celebrate 10 years of their iconic cleansing balm, which has been one of my favourites for well over a year, so I'm very excited. As you might know if you've been here for a while, I'm very introverted and socially anxious, so I do find events quite difficult. I am, however, eternally grateful, of course, for the invites, and even if I don't necessarily speak to many people, I try to make sure I push myself to turn up. I was absolutely flabbergasted by this feature. You push a button and a bubble is released into this basin thing, and then it bursts and smells like that particular cleansing balm. I was also very happy to see that they're releasing a limited edition green fig cleansing balm. I love a fig and I love an Elemis cleansing balm, so what a beautiful combination. I didn't end up staying for long, so I went for a little stroll around Covent Garden, but I could not resist having a look inside the goodie bag. They very kindly included two full-sized cleansing balms, including the green fig one, which is so fun. I popped into Penhaligon's because I've never actually been inside one of their shops before, but I didn't end up buying anything. Their bottles are so beautiful though, and I really wanted to eat that green soap. I had a look around Charlotte Tilbury, and then I went into Kiko because I saw that they've released a little mermaid collection. I swatched a couple of their eyeshadows, but they felt a teeny bit chalky to me, and Kiko was actually so much more expensive than I remember. That first eyeshadow quad was $17.49. Lastly, I went into Space NK because I wanted to buy the new Hourglass skin tint, but I wasn't sure what shade I would be. The Lady Colour matched me to number one, which is the lightest shade with a cool to neutral undertone, so I bought that and headed home. It would have been rude not to try on the cap from the Elemis goodie bag. Stunning. When I got home, I was very excited to see a PR parcel from Charlotte Tilbury. These are her beach sticks. They're a limited edition trio that can be used on your cheeks and your lips, and my mother has already claimed all three of them. She deserves them. The middle one, Las Salinas, looks like such a beautiful blusher shade. Then for some reason I felt the need to sit on the floor while I unpacked the Elemis goodie bag. These baby ones are so sweet, and my current favourite balm is actually the rose one. I know some people quite dislike a rose scent, but I love it. I find it so soothing and comforting. The pop-up was only running for 3 days, so I'm really grateful I got to go to it. And I know I always say I want to eat products, but I absolutely particularly want to eat this one, and the scent as well. Delicious. Talking of delicious, I made myself a smoothie to tide me over until dinner, and then I took my makeup off using the new fig cleansing balm. It has the same consistency, etc. as the other Elemis ones, it just has this beautiful fig scent as well. I had an early night, and then the next day I was off to a perfume workshop at the Experimental Perfume Club, again in Covent Garden. This shirt is new from Suzanne, by the way. How pretty are these little embroidered hearts? If it's still in stock, I'll pop a direct link in the description box. Gucci Flora is my favourite perfume of all time, so I brought that along with me for reference. I actually booked this workshop about a month in advance because they sell out so quickly. This is the Apprentice workshop, so for absolute beginners, it was £150 and it lasts for 3.5 hours. The workshops are held downstairs and we all got our own little workstation. The lady who ran the workshop was also the founder of the company, and she set it up a few years ago after working as a perfumer herself for big brands. We started with this exercise where we had to guess 25 different ingredients, and I got maybe 3 correct. I did have a bit of a headache after that activity because of all of the different smells, so I was very grateful for the 15-minute break. I got a green juice from a nearby cafe, which was lovely, but £7. Being me though, I did appreciate the alone time, even if it was just for a few minutes. Then we got to the main portion of the workshop, which was designing and making our own perfumes. My smooth brain didn't quite appreciate that we would be calculating and measuring out the ingredients ourselves, but it was really fun. We decided on the ingredients, what percentage of each one we wanted, and then we converted those percentages into grams. And finally, we spent about 30 minutes actually making our perfume. I called mine Parfum de Olivia Soros Rex, and I was elated to see that they printed it out and stuck it on the bottle. What a pinch me moment. I learned a lot and had so much fun, so I'd highly recommend the course. I got home to a few PR parcels, so I thought we could unbox them together. Glow Recipe is Cult Beauty's brand of the month, so they sent me this fun little puffer bag with some Glow Recipe products inside. Their retinol eye cream, hyaluronic acid serum and lip mask are top 5 products for me, so I cannot wait to try these. La Roche-Posay sent over some of their sun protection products, which in my opinion are some of the best affordable options, and then GHD sent over this very unexpected parcel. This is their limited edition Helios professional hairdryer. The following day was Saturday, which is Putty Cleanout Day. Putty is an 8-week-old Russian dwarf hamster, and I've had her since she was 4 weeks old, so about a month now. I don't know why I ordered such a gigantic playpen for her. She was quite bewildered by all the open space, and I was paranoid that she'd be able to climb up the sides, so I ended up popping her in her little travel case. which I then put on the sofa so I didn't trip over her while I was cleaning her cage. She is such a sweet, gentle little girl who has not so much as nibbled me once, but she was not impressed, so I fed her some broccoli, but she ended up eating the broccoli while continuing to try to escape her little travel case. Poor little Fluff, she's clearly good at multitasking though, and then after a couple of minutes of that, she fell asleep. I really do have to stop myself from squishing her, she's so sweet. It took me about 20 minutes to deep clean her cage, and she is a curious little blob, so I want to make sure she gets enough sensory stimulation. I swap in different items each week when I clean her out, and this time it was adding this new wooden house up on the balcony. Once it was all ready, I put the open travel case inside the cage so that she could discover for herself where she was and make her own way out. She was still asleep though, so I gently stroked her little chin until she woke up and emerged. She looked so cosy and warm in her bedding, so I felt a bit bad, but needs must. It did take her a few seconds to work out where she was, but once she knew she could go back into her cage, she jumped in. Or at least she tried to. I was about to help her, but then plop, in she went. As is usually the case once I've cleaned her out, she zoomed around for a bit, sniffed some things, especially her new house, and then eventually wandered into her cotton bedding under the balcony and fell asleep. I'm not convinced she'll actually be able to fit in the top level of her new house, but we shall see. I slept so well on Saturday night and did my usual morning routine on Sunday. I don't think I've shared this with you previously, and some elements are quite new, so let's go through how I spend the first 90 minutes or so of my day. Depending on how I'm feeling and how well I slept, the first thing I do when I wake up is meditate for either 10 or 15 minutes. I used to use Headspace for guided meditations, but now I just set the timer on my phone and meditate in silence. My little routine is first getting comfortable and making sure my posture is good, then softening my focus and taking around 5 deep breaths, breathing in through the nose and out through the mouth. I gently close my eyes on the last out breath and start focusing my attention on my normal breath, specifically focusing on the feeling of the air passing in and out of my nostrils. If I catch myself thinking, I try not to judge myself and instead just softly waft the thought away and refocus on my breath. Then after making my bed, I shower and do my skincare routine. One product I've just started using is the Medicate Day Eye Cream with SPF 30, which I absolutely love. I'm so happy to find an eye cream with sun protection, especially because that area is so thin and delicate. One thing I didn't mention is that I don't go on my phone, apart from to set the timer for meditation, for the first hour of the day. I eat my breakfast and have a mug or two of coffee while watching my favourite YouTubers. I use this time just to be present and enjoy the slowness. I've managed to keep this up for a couple of weeks now, and Curb is absolutely shocked by my discipline. This is also around the time that Putty tends to wake up for a snack, and I love hearing her nibbling next to me. Once the hour is up, I check my socials and respond to comments and messages on Instagram and TikTok for about 20 minutes. I'm extremely fortunate that the vast majority of people who follow me on social media are lovely, so this time is a highlight of my day. This is a bit random, but I also love admiring bits and bobs around my flat that I've collected. This oil painting is by a Japanese artist who now lives in the English countryside, and looking at it gives me so much joy. On a less joyous note, I'm currently reading The Secret by Rhonda Byrne after doing an Instagram poll, and I've been periodically sharing my thoughts on my stories. I am personally not a fan of this book. On a side note, I have been obsessed with these KOI's tinted lip balms ever since they sent them to me. For transparency, I did a paid partnership on these balms for TikTok about a month ago, but I adore them. They are so soft and luxurious. I can't stop reapplying this clear one because I'm addicted to the taste, so I'm nearly out, but I also keep this one on my desk and then the other 4 in the collection on my chest of drawers. My mum has claimed the one on the far left, so I'm trying to resist it. Anyway, aside from being distracted by pretty things, I like to replace my affirmation card every Sunday and give myself a second to absorb the message. Sunday is also nail refresh day. I really need better storage for my nail products, I know, but today I'm going to go with Bluebell by Nailberry, which is this beautiful purple. I really love the SE Gel top coat because it prevents chipping during the week so well. I really try to keep Sundays free, but I do often end up filming at least one video because I work during the week. The clips I'm showing are me applying the finishing touches or refilming particular scenes because I'm not happy with them. Maybe they were slightly out of focus the first time or the lighting was slightly off. Filming in natural light is always a challenge because it constantly changes throughout filming. Each video takes me about 3 hours from start to finish. I actually managed to film 4 short videos in one sitting, which is unheard of for me. These are the items I filmed videos about. Single product videos are so much easier to film and edit. This squishy blusher by Unleashia kept distracting me because it feels so nice. I had a deadline of the following day for the first draft of a sponsored TikTok post, so I spent time editing on my phone, and then I migrated over to my desk to start editing this video. Bit of inception for you there. This seems like a good time to close this vlog out. I loved spending the weekend with you and I hope you enjoyed watching.